What is good, friends? Bringing you more World Cup coverage. Funkasaurus versus White Lion, and the score is 3-2 for Team India. White Lion playing for Team India. And yeah, US Metro is looking to make the score even with 3-3. So this is black and white. I usually don't record black and white, but this is a World Cup, and if I do get the chance, I might record some of them. Okay, so looking at White Lion's team, it's probably gonna be I can see Rocks, T-Tar, Spike, Skarmory, maybe Sub SD Chomp and Scarf, Keldo, Scarf, Hydreigon. I think Hydreigon would be Specs, Kelly would be Scarf, but yeah, not 100% sure about that, my guys. The music is playing, right? Okay, nice. It's early in the morning here, I just finished recording the AIM game. Why is my computer sound so high? It should be fine. He goes on this Among Us. I know Among Us sometimes carries Sleep Talk to absorb opposing, like to absorb Spore. Exactly, see, it's a Sleep Talk, exactly. And he gets a stun Spore on a Tita, which is pretty clutch. Okay, so looking at Funkasaurus' team. He has a Jealous into like Spin Block and Wall Keldeo, kind of. Is this Banter or is this... I think it's gonna be like a special attacker Jirachi is what I see a lot with Calm Mind. Okay, so the Cheetah throws up the rocks, which makes me think that it's a Scarf Landris. If it's not Rocks Lando, which we already know, and he sacks off his Cheetah, doesn't get the para that I was... Like, I know Cheetah carries superpower sometimes, like, I know I didn't really talk about this play, but it was a bit weird going Cheetah on Cheetah. I probably would have gone Keldeo instead. Like, not that I'm like the black and white gold or anything, but I know a little bit. So yeah, this Keldeo pretty much gets walled by Jellicent, so I can see a double switch into Hydreigon here. On the other side, they can also see just a safe play, which would just be clicking the water move, or like water fighting, and Jellicent is immune or resist, like it has, its ability makes it immune to the water move, so it can scald burn it, and it's immune to the fighting move, so this is like tough. But yeah, double into Hydreigon would be, if it works out, would be a really cool play. Did he go into Jellicent? So he goes Among Us, which is a mid ground play. That's a nice mid ground play, yeah. Maybe scouting for some super effective hidden power on Jellicent, which would be hidden power grass, electric, or ghost, or something along those lines. But I'm not really sure what hidden power Keldeo is carrying this gen. So yeah, the Hydreigon, I mean, I do see hidden power. I think I've seen ghost, because it hits like Jellicent, Starmie, Celebi, all that goodness. But I'm pretty sure there's a better hidden power. He goes for Fire Blast and did absolutely nothing to bulky Cheetah. And yeah, the Skarmory comes in for free, like, this basically does laughable damage. He still takes rocks. And yeah, he's gonna get up a layoff spike here on a Cheetah. The Hydreigon Fire Blast did 14% to a bulky Tyranitar. Is this Jirachi threatens the Skarmory as a potential electric move here? As I did want to run a Kulk real quick, I'm in black and white, right? So let's say lead Cheetah versus... No, it's not lead Cheetah, I wanted to say support. So if I'm a white line, I'd probably switch out into... Oh, he gets a crit with hidden power. Is that hidden power ice? Predicting the guard jump, predicting the electric move? So that's a Spidef Skarmory for sure, eats it up. But now he's forced to switch out, which I can see him going for... HP ice here, predicting one of those three, if it's HP ice. I'm not sure what other hidden power it could be. It was neutral, so... But yeah, I just wanted to calc the Hydreigon damage on the Tyranitar from early on to see if it's Specs Hydreigon or Scarf Hydreigon. Let's say Tyranitar. OU support. Fire Blast does 14 to 17 from Choice Specs Hydreigon. So it could be Choice Specs Hydreigon, because that's to max HP T-Tar, but with Spidef too. He goes for Fire Punch, so he's like a mixed Jirachi, which is interesting. So he was maybe predicting the Among Us there. And also would have hit the Skarmory in front of him. As he goes back out in a Skarmory. So this is a cool play. If Funkasaurus is running a lot of speed, he can potentially taunt the opposing Skarmory and prevent the roost, but maybe he doesn't have taunt. Skarmory does get taunt in Gen 5, I'm not tripping, right? Yeah, it should. So they're both exchanging spikes and they both don't have hazard control, so this is gonna be... yeah, this is actually not gonna be that long of a game because this hazard's wearing down each other's team. Sleep Talk to Spore, this Among Us is really reliable. First it's Sleep Talk to Stun Spore, now to Spore. And yeah, it's really hard to bring something in for free besides... Like, Hydreigon can kind of switch in because it only takes rocks, but it also takes Sandstorm. But yeah, I think he's gonna click Draco here. Because last time the T-Tech came out and it's... This is kind of tough. He can also click Dark Pulse if he predicts the Jelly Scent on a mid-ground. But nah, I think Draco... Nah, Draco would just nuke the Jelly Scent anyway. So I assume we're gonna see Draco here. And he goes for Surf, which is the one play I wouldn't expect to come out. Yeah, IBR saying we're not Draco too. Finally someone agreeing with me, that's cool to see. Even though I'm not good at... Well, not really... I don't really have experience at Black and White, but... I probably would've clicked Draco there, breaking the Tar slash Jelly Scent. Dark Pulse would've been the other option, if you were really sure that he wouldn't go T-Tar. Like, he wasn't staying in there with Skarmory, that's what I know. They said misclick both, good lord. Not sure if one of them is trolling, but yeah, it's a free Among Us pretty much, as it's asleep, so it can't get gold burned. And I assume we're gonna see the Skarmory here. The Skarmory switch from Funkasaurus is part, as that can pretty much switch in for free on the Among Us. It only takes some rocks, and he goes back into a dragon, which is a cool play and all that, but he gets worn down. And... This time Funkasaurus might stay in with the Skarmory predicting the Draco Meteor. He does need the Skarmory, kind of. Like, the Skarmory is pretty nice to have, you don't want to just sack it. He sacks off the Cheetah pretty much, because it's gonna get blown away by this Draco. Like, even if he went for Fire Blast, the hazard damage plus the Cheetah being paralyzed pretty much made it a dead Cheetah in my mind. Like, that's how I see it. So he sends out the Jirachi. Minus 2 Hydreigon locked in a Draco Meteor, if I'm not mistaken here, with my Kulk and everything should be choiced. So this could go for HP Ice here, slash Fire Punch. And Skarmory eats it up. So now he might try to pivot. White Lion might try to pivot into something. On a Fire Punch slash on a T-Bolt. So... I'd probably go for HP Ice again, because he knows that you have Fire Punch. Yeah, he goes for HP Ice again, but he doesn't switch, he just doesn't care, and he gets a Wilbon into a Jellicent. Which is not the worst for Funkasaurus, that you can just click recover unless the Skarmory is packing taunt. But it seems the last move is probably gonna be Brave Bird on the Skarmory. As a Jellicent is pretty much free to click Scald or Will-O-Wisp, I was about to say, but on the other hand, I was like, in the back of my mind, I was like, he's probably gonna go Among Us, so I would double predicting that. But I guess he doesn't have a reason to make any plays like that at the moment, as he's gets the Wilwind out and get a nice T-Bolt damage off on the Skarmory, but the Skarmory is a nuisance for his team. I don't know if I would have let the Skarmory let him get burned. HP Fire does laughable damage, even though Hidden Power is like 70 base power in Gen 5. I mean, I assume the last move is gonna be Brave Bird, so this should be the Among Us 1-on-1. The Among Us will eventually be kind of forced out here. Skarmory is gonna go for a Roost one more time. Okay, goes for Whirlwind. I thought we would go for a Roost one more time. In case the Among Us stays in. But yeah, now White Lion is just gonna Roost as Funkasaurus burns a sleep turn. I mean, the Hydreigon is just so low. I don't know if I would have gone hard to Hydreigon. I was just trying to talk about the endgame. Where if the Hydreigon goes down, the Jellicent kind of walls everything. Oh, he goes hard into Jellicent and risks it. Oh, never mind. Okay, so much about Jellicent walling everything. It just gets blown away by this Draco. I thought he might want to keep the Jellicent because it basically walls like the Kelio. I don't think Among Us can really touch it either. But I guess they can't touch each other that much. SAS Scarf HP Ice comes out here from the Landorus. I assume it's Scarf. Like, I guess Jason vs. Moose would be an 8th matchup, because they, like, Giga Ram doesn't do much, because it's a weak, Moose is weak, Jason is bulky. Jason also can't do much to Moose, so that would be eh. But yeah, the permanent weather, like, making Pokemon take sandstorm damage and all these hazards, plus the specs Hydreigon making this game actually not lasting that long, because there's like some bulky shit with Skarmory going on, but Wurlbun and Spikes just getting consistent chip damage off. And I do actually need something to eat, but yeah, that's fine. I'll finish recording this for you guys. I actually wanted to add Porsche to the call if he was down, but I was working on a summon for my last upload and I couldn't even finish and this game already started, so I didn't have time to ask anyone. And it's early in the morning, but I usually like to add a black and white expert if I have the opportunity to, at least someone who plays the tier. Maybe expert is not the wrong term, it's not the correct term here. But yeah, he just gets off the HPI's damage predicting Whirlwind slash Roost. I mean, I think he was predicting Whirlwind, because if you were predicting Roost, he would have hard switched as the Skarmory finally dies. So that might have been a roll. I do want to calc this. I think we have seen it do 45 earlier with Skarmory. Skarmory Spidef. So this is the Thunder set on Jirachi. I don't know how much this T-Bolt set runs. Super Rachi, Offensive Calm Mind. Nah, I don't know the exact spread he's running. If he was Max Special Attack, which I don't think he is because he's looking to be like mixed, T-Bolt would have done. Wait, so much? What the fuck? Oh, that's Impish Skarmory. Let's say Max Spidef, careful. I would have done 65, so I assume this is not gonna be. Yeah, this mod is Life Orb. Yeah, it's not Life Orb. Let's say this spread. It does 46 to 55 with this spread. How much has it done earlier? It has done 51, so yeah, it might be that spread with like 108 investment. But yeah, what happened here in the last turn? He killed the Skarmory, the Kelly came out and clicked Surf, Jirachi fainted, okay. So he didn't want to go hard on Mungus, because with all the hazards it would have been actually scary to switch in. So it's coming close down, he's gonna click Giga Drain here, I assume, not wanting to play around with the Kellyo, exactly. And this Amoongus is gonna like sleep talk, because sleep chance is how it works in Black and White. They reset if you switch out, so it's pretty much confirmed to not wake up. So it's safe to click sleep talk, because you know that you won't wake up. And HP fire is not much, but Funkasaur is still in a better position here unless his opponent pulls a stun spore. Just going to Garchomp here, which is a cool play, as that should eat up. I mean, White Lion let everything take damage. I think. How much did the Kelly do? The Kelly only used one move so far, right? So we don't know. It only used Scarf on Jirachi in the 26, so we don't know if it's Scarf or Specs. It should be Scarf looking at the team, and knowing the Hydreigon was probably Specs, it should be Scarf Kelly. And yeah, this Fire Blast Garchomp, well. Nice play. Catching the thing on the switch. And yes, Scarflanders is gonna get a kill here with. Catching the Skarm on the switch, not the thing. Scarflan is gonna click Earthquake here. I don't see what you lose from clicking Earthquake. As this is actually gonna come down pretty close, because Amoongus can't switch well into Kellyo. If Kellyo has Hidden Power Ice or something along those lines, I don't know if it gets Ice even in Gen 5. And it if it has that, it basically gets a kill if it comes in on the Landorus. Icy Wind is a Gen 2 move, so I think it should get it, yeah. Surprisingly, I'm not that. I'm kind of surprised I'm not that tired. It's like 6:50 in the morning. Whew. I mean, Funkasaur is going to be clicking EQ 100%. This can live another round of spikes and rocks, I think. So. He could sack Amoongus and keep the Garchomp, but is that worth it is a question. Amoongus probably gonna be able to take one hit from Landorus. He can't switch in though. But then you would have to sleep talk the correct thing. So I think sacking Amoongus might be the play, and then Kellyo should be able to get a kill if it has an ice move. Let me actually check how much my upload has gone. Okay, it's at 88%. That's actually interesting, like how World Cup is already getting hyped and everything. Like 121 people and it's like 6:50 in Europe in the morning. It's like almost 1 AM in America, I think, yeah. This is gonna suck off. Oh, what? What? I thought he would have gone Among Us. Going Hard Kelly, I don't think was the play. Oh, that's really confusing to me. That wasn't the play. Nice, someone agreeing with me, finally. Okay, so this makes me think, did he Scarf Chomp the way this has been played? But like, Scarf Chomp, what? Does he have like something to kill this? I guess he's just gonna click Outrage. Because that's like the strongest move to hit both of these. Yeah, if Outrage kills... We can calc real quick. Oh. Guard Chomp, Choice Scarf. I don't know if he's Choice Scarf even with Landris. I'm really confused as to how this played out. Outrage does, if you take the Intimidate away, 66 to 79, so it would be a Roland Funkasaurus player. Yeah, I think Funkasaurus wins this game. Okay, he didn't realize the jump saves. Okay, that was not the wrong play, it was the correct play, okay? Okay, I take everything back. So, I probably, that's literally the right play, damn. I finally thought I had got something correct, and then I got just see I got they're talking down the play. So yeah, this is probably Scarf Chomp then. Otherwise, I just don't understand the play. So what was the kill to then? At first, when I saw the team, I thought this Scarf Chomp would be either Sub SD or what was the other set that I was thinking about? Yachi or Gem? Even though I don't really know how common that is. But he sacks off Among Us to get off an Intimidate on the Garchomp. And it might come down to Sleep Talk, what Among Us pulls with Sleep Talks. I mean, he already wasted his crit on the one thing. I don't think he's gonna get another one. So if Among Us pulls a Giga Drain or Spore, it can win the game here for White Line. So this is gonna come down to the last turn. Man, I thought I finally made a decent Black-White narration, and I just saw... Damn it, that I was wrong that one turn where I thought it was the correct play. I mean, I love close games, but oof. So hard to who I want to root for, because like I know Sidurt's on Metro, I know BTB on India, and India's like they have like some unknown players. It's like it would be cool for them to make it in. Yes, oh, that just killed. So Metro picks up the win. We will calc real quick if that was a potential roll between Landris and Among Us. Let's say OU Wall. 54-64. Wait, I don't know what floor gift does. Wait. 54-64. So if that's Bedev Among Us. So I think Bedev Among Us has ran to pivot in on certain special attackers, like maybe had Dragon, but actually don't think so, because Specs had Dragon would still blow you away. It's mainly for Keldeos, if they have Hidden Power Ice, I assume. What else would this Bedev be for in Among Us? I guess to take Fireblast from Chomp or stuff like that, Fireblast from Tita, but yeah, not the Black and White expert, my bad guys. It was still okay besides some little parts. Why the fuck did he put those things? Yeah, he's excited that he won, okay. Funkasaurus picks up the win versus White Line. The score is 3-3 now between US Metro and India. And oh my lordy. It's gonna come on the DPP and ADV. Oh, never mind. Yeah, Obi's also still playing. Yeah. Sucks if. I hope the DPP or ADV game is 40 Sun Moon game, but I don't think it will be. Because I don't know these tiers and I don't really want to record them. But it would be really cool if the Sun and Moon game is like the deciding one. And I don't have to record this one and can like catch this live to like give you the end score of the series. But I doubt, I think the OB game might be first, like probably. Yeah, thank you guys for watching. I mean... Let me know if this was somewhat okay. I know my Black and White isn't the best, like my knowledge and stuff. Covering a bit more game, a few more games later on, so stay tuned for that. Like I said in my earlier upload, not sure yet if I'm gonna be covering the Latin America vs. Bangladeshi last games because they don't matter anymore. But maybe they will play just for fun and I'll record them. So stay tuned mainly for the series that still matters, but yeah. Stay tuned in general for the upcoming World Cup after the qualifier is over, and Dockridge signing out. Peace, friends.